I need to get those defensive batteries online, so make this fast. The comm spike traces and decrypts coded signals. As long as you have the transponder ID, you can track pretty much anything. That file you lifted from the Galbank archives contained the Legacy's transponder code, which I'll program into your nav system. All you have to do is get within the vicinity of Bannock 4, and the comm spike will automatically point you to the target. Cute toy, huh? Well, you already know that the conduction grid does a pretty nifty trick. It absorbs extreme voltage and converts it to usable power on Neon. The version for your ship can still absorb incoming electrical energy, like, say, the EM field surrounding Bannock 4, but it can't store the power. Instead, it just scatters the EM harmlessly away from the hull, insulating you from frying every circuit aboard. As a nice side effect, I'm betting the module will make your ship somewhat EM weapon resistant and boost its shield regen. Lucky you. There are three defensive batteries, basically high-powered military space turrets, triangulated around the key. They were part of the UC's original defenses for the station. Pretty effective, too. Can put some serious hurt on enemy spacecraft. The good news is that the batteries have an incredibly wide field of coverage, so they can pick off ships trying to reach the key from any vector. The bad news is that they're 100-year-old tech. They keep breaking down and are expensive as hell to keep operational. Not a problem. Conduction grid data is all set up in the system, so should be an easy install. Sounds like fun. Let's see what I've got.
Every captain here's earned their stripes.
We hunt piracy all across the galaxy.
Wherever the Crimson Fleet go, we'll
fight. All support ships have arrived, Commander.
Good. After we're done here, arrange it briefly. I want all of their CEOs over here as soon as possible.
Yes, sir.
There you are. Where have you been? I've received the reports about that stunt you pulled inside of Genadine. Opening fire inside a civilian facility. Are you out of your mind?
Genadine is furious at us right now. They want Commander Riconde to resign.
You always have a choice. People have died because you were too stubborn to find a safer solution. This is not how you see SysDev operates. I don't care if we're one step away from Crix's legacy. If you do it again, you're off this operation, and I'll have Toph throw you in the brig.
It'll be my pleasure, sir.
All right. I think we're all in agreement here. So let's get back to the operation at hand. It's time to put all the cards on the table and prepare to attack the key. Thanks to your evidence, we are finally able to convince them to task us the necessary resources. Before you jump to Bannock 4, I need to make one thing abundantly clear. The credits from that Galbank transport cannot reach the fleet. You have to bring them here at all costs. If Delgado gains access to those resources, we might be touching off a battle we can't possibly win.
We've been monitoring the Crimson Fleet's comm chatter in the Crix system. They're gathering allies by making promises based on your success.
As much as I hate to admit it, UCC's death won't stand a chance. The fleet will become stronger and more unified than ever.
You cannot help but admire their commitment to their mission.
The only admiration I hold for the Crimson Fleet is the fact that they aren't going to be a problem for much longer.
Hey, don't worry about it. You've come this far. We know you've got what it takes to bring the prize home.
Well said, Lieutenant. All right, I guess this is it. Do whatever prep you need to do aboard the Vigilance, and then head out to Bannock 4. When you return here with Crix's legacy, we'll begin the attack. Good luck. During the end of the Narian War, the money was destined to bolster the Freestar Collective's coffers. Even though we were rivals at the time, and I suppose we still are to some extent, the credits still rightfully belong to their people. After the money is turned over to Mast, I'm certain arrangements will be made to return the money to the proper authorities in Aquila City. The evidence you've been bringing to Lieutenant Toft has been instrumental in convincing the brass at Mast to greenlight the attack. They've sent us support ships, extra troops, weapons. All on account of your role in the operation. To put it simply, if it wasn't for you, this operation would be at a standstill. Stay focused and be careful out there.
Has something on your mind?
You come back alive. You.
Fleet call us sharks. They know what happens.
Need anything before you head to Bannock? This is your moment. I know you can do this.
I woke up in the middle of the night once and found Ensign Betty tinkering with some machine.
Thank you. business. Try not to forget who you are, okay? It'd break the commander's heart to have to hunt you down.
Where we left it? The damage done here certainly indicates we are not the first to find the ship.
Everything here appears sound. The crew must have remained trapped for some time.
Always worth checking. Never know what you might find in their pockets. Like this traded by smugglers, but never one that is functional. This must be decades old. Thank you.
give up already. You cannot beat me!
Best not leave anything useful behind.
have anything of value?
Recording initiated.
Well, now, let's see. Another day's gone by. What's it been now? 6 weeks? Who the hell knows? Food packs from my ship are gone, so it looks like the clock's running down for me, and Issa wins. What a clever woman.
Crew recording initiated.
Son of a bitch! Nothing. Complete waste of time. I've tried everything I can possibly think of, and I end up right where I started. Oh, here, I thought I was so clever. Thought I had it all figured out. First, fix my ship and get the prototype shielding back online. Second, shunt the power from the cred tank array back to the system to drain the credits. And then third, haul ass back to my ship before the EM field rips apart the legacy. 3 easy steps, right? Only problem is, I'm stuck at step 1. Every system on my ship is dead, and there's nothing aboard this ship to use for repairs. I can't believe I came all this way, just to end up stuck here like the poor bastards who ran this ship.
External communication detected. Automated recording system activated.
Legacy, come in. This is Issa Melante. Are you there, Legacy?
Holy shit. Issa, is that you? Issa, I'm here. Yes, I can read you.
Jasper Creeks. You still alive? Always were one tough son of a bitch.
Yeah. I'm alive. No thanks to you. A month? Really? You left me to sit here and panic for a month. We said you'd wait a week. Tops!
Wait a moment. I think broadcasting from outside the EM field is interfering with my comms. Did I just hear Jasper Creeks the Great admit that he was panicking about something?
Yeah, yeah. How about we cut the crap and you get my ass out of here? Come on, there has to be millions of credits here. We're rich!
You know what? I think I'm going to pass. Rich. After you left, remember how you temporarily placed me in charge of the fleet? Right then, I decided to make the job permanent. All I had to do was make some alterations to your sheeting plans. Mainly the footnotes where the I even paid a tech to ensure a few of your ship's power connections were dodgy. Just in case.
The ship can no longer counter the EM field. We need to leave now!
Frankly, I'm surprised those shields held long enough for you to make it to the storm.
What the hell? You killed Fulterty. I'm in charge of the fleet.
Blah, blah, blah. Yes, I thought that was clean. I'm in charge.
Journey,
the technology simply doesn't exist without stupid eyes. And don't quote me the fleet's motto. I listened to that bullshit for years.